In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to create all these two amazing text effect design in Adobe Illustrator. For the first design, as you can see, it's a linear geometric text design where we have used the transform tool to get this perspective look. And for the second design, we have used the revolve option, 3D revolve option in Adobe Illustrator, and we have applied a nice texture to it. So we'll create a texture, pattern texture, and apply it to the surface and create all this perspective looking geometric design. So in our previous video, we have seen how to create this nice parallel wave design, and we have also looked at how to create this circular ring effect pattern using the blending option and the make with mesh option. And in the first tutorial, we have seen how to create this nice abstract design using the line segments and the make with mesh option, and we have clipped it to the circle. Whereas for the second design, we have used the transform option, free transform option, and created this nice perspective look. So let's begin with our designing process. Let's see how to create our first design. It's very simple. We're gonna first create our nice rectangle. So let's create a rectangle using the rectangle tool. So I'll go to rectangle tool and draw out a strip. Just click and drag and fill this up with black color. Okay, after that we'll create a duplicate, 9 duplicate of this. So the easier way is to create a duplicate using the transform tool option. So let's select that. Okay, and we'll go to effect, okay, distort and transform, and under transform here we'll set the copies to around 8 more copies, and we'll move this vertically down, so something like that. And let's give a nice decent spacing between them, and I think this is fine, and I'll click OK, and there we go. We have created 9 copies of the same strip. So now let's expand this. So we'll go to object and expand appearance. Okay, and object, expand. There we go. Now let's type in our text. So for this we need edge. So I'll just type edge. Okay, and there we go. Let's scale up the size and let's fill this up with white color for now. Okay, and there it is. And for this we have used the Arial Black, a regular font, and let's scale this up the same size of the parallel design, and let's expand this object, expand appearance, and click OK. There we go. Now I'll just select these anchor points, or maybe directly select the shape, extend it until the edges. Okay, and let's place it around here. That's fine. Now using direct selection tool, select these two anchor points and just make it parallel to this shape. So just see. Okay, in the same way, we'll select these and place it parallel to this, and there we go. Now after this, next thing, let's create a copy of this. So with the alt or option key, just click and drag and create under duplicate of this. Okay, let's make it a little bit thinner, and I'll just place it around here. We'll use it later. Now select them both, select this and the text shape, and make sure your text is on the top, and selecting them both, we'll go to pathfinder, right, and under pathfinder click on crop, and this will crop out the intersection region, and that's how we got this nice text. Now next thing we're gonna do is to apply the perspective look. So what we can do is we can just bring this one around here, okay, parallel to the design, and under copy around there, and make sure they're attached properly, something like that, and there we go. Now select both, right, select all the shapes, and we'll go to transform tool here, free transform tool, and under transform tool just click free transform, and from here we'll select the anchor point and just drag it up, and with the shift press you can make sure it's straight line. So with the shift press I'll drag it up. There we go. And we'll give a little bit of angle to this. As you can see, we have given a angle here, huge angle, and a little bit of angle there. So we'll give a little slight angle, just raise it up a little bit, something like this, and there we go. Now we'll select this, ungroup everything, right, select the individual shapes, this one, and I'm going to use the same tool, that is free distort, select the point and drag it down, something like that, little bit of this as well, just little bit down, little bit, just to give that little bit of angular look. In the same way, I'll select this other shape, select the distort tool, okay, and just click and drag it down around like that, and little bit of down for that as well, and let's see what else is there. And I think we can just give it a little bit of depth and a little bit of angular tilt, and let's see. And here you can see there are two extra pieces. We can just delete that, double click inside, delete this piece, and zoom out, and there we go. we got our text, etch text, using the parallel lines. We have used the free transform tool, and under that we have used the free distort tool, and we got that effect. Now next, let's look at how to create out this second design. It's a dynamic swirl of black and white strip forming a circular vortex-like pattern. So let's look at how to create this. So first of all, let's create the strips. So to create that, I'm gonna use the rectangle tool, okay, and create a rectangle something like this. Very simple. Okay, and now we'll create a duplicate. So we can use the shortcut Alt or Option key, press, click and drag it out and create a duplicate, right? Once you have created one duplicate, you can create multiple number of duplicates using the shortcut Command or Control D. Just press Command or Control D continuously until you get this, right? Something like that. And once you are happy with this, you can just select everything, right? And we'll convert this into symbols. So we'll go to symbol over here and just drag and drop it there, okay? And give it a name, whatever, like strip, strip strips, okay? And click OK, and this will create add a symbol to your palette over here. We can just delete this now. Now let's create this circular 3D shape. So to create that, I'm going to use the ellipse tool and draw out a small circle. So with the shift, press, click and drag and to create a nice circular shape, something like this. And let's give it a stroke thickness. So I'll change the color to white and we'll apply this color to the stroke. So just click over here to reverse it, and the colors will be applied to the stroke. Now next thing I'm gonna do is to apply 3D revolve option. So selecting the shape, go to effect, 3D materials, and here we're gonna go to 3D classic, where we can click on revolve. So click on it and this will create this nice circular 3D shape. We can just adjust the angles here, and to add a circular gap in between, you can just click on offset, and this will increase the size of these circles. So we'll keep it around, let's say 28 or maybe around 31, fine. And let's set the angle properly. I'll set this to this side, something like this, and give it a bit of angular. And I think this looks good. I'm click OK, and there we go. Now next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna add these patterns, strips. So we'll go to appearance, right? And again, go into 3D Revolve Classic. Here, we'll go to map art. And under map art, we got two surfaces. So let's check which surfaces are top surface. So let's select the first surface and click on strip. And this will add the strip, but it's not visible. So now it's not the top surface. I just cleared this out. Let's go to second surface and we'll add the strip again here. And there we go. We can see that strip over there. Just change the angle. So if you play, go nearer, you see this arrow, just click and drag, and with the shift press, you can snap it to right angles. So I place it here. Let's increase the size from this side, and from top and bottom as well. So just extend this according to a grid. And as you can see, there you go. And after that, I'll click OK. And over here, I'll just adjust the angle of rotation. You can just adjust the angle of rotation here, very easy. And there we go. We can set the angle a little bit, something like this. You can even give a little bit of perspective, something like that. But I think I like the flat shape, something like that, and click OK. And there we go. Now I'll just expand this. So go to Object, Expand Appearance. Again, go to Object, Expand, and just ungroup everything. Ungroup, and we'll release clipping mask, and there we go. Now we'll select the top surfaces. So select this, 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 and let's see. Okay, we have selected everything. I'll just place this here and select all the shapes from the background, delete it out, and there we go. I'll just place this back over here, and let's scale up the size according to our design. And we can just give a little bit of angle there just to get that look. And there we go, we have created our second design as well. Very simple. We have used the 3D revolve option under effect, 3D material, 3D classic revolve, and we have applied map art. We have adjusted the angle here, and that way we have created this black and white strip forming a circular vortex like pattern. And that's how we have created these two designs. For the first design, we have used free transform tool, and we have used a free distort option to adjust the angles individually, each corners perfectly. And we did the same for the other two strips here, and that way we got this nice perspective looping text. You can apply this technique and create your own amazing designs. We're gonna work on some more amazing design concepts, so see you in the next video.